Hi there, this is Melody Pash, and I just want to talk to you about the Now Interpret This Dream Journal. If you have purchased one of these, I am so grateful, and I hope that you're using it and it's beneficial to you. This is one of the reasons why I wrote this book or published this book is because I really wanted a template that worked well for me and took care of all the pieces that needed to be in my dreams or that I needed to look at, process through in my interpretation. So when you first open the book, there are going to be a few pages. Let me get where you can see this. There are going to be a few pages that kind of tell you about some of the dreams that have been very important to me and actually directed my whole life. They have affected my whole life for many, 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 many years. Then the templates begin right after that, and you can see where I've been writing my dreams. I'm very faithful to write my dreams, but I want to just go over the template with you. Don't want to forget to tell you, though, in the back there is a small dictionary with lots of terms, symbols that need interpretations, that have the interpretations in the back of the book there, as well as colors and numbers, some numbers. So you have that as well. It's all there in your journal, which works really nicely. But really quickly, I just want to talk to you about the template. Now, the first thing you have is your date and time, or your day and date. I always like to put the date on these because it's very important sometimes on the anniversary of it, a week later, a month later, 6 months later, or a year later. Sometimes dreams are like a prophetic utterance or prophetic message or a reading where Creator God is giving you information about what's to come, and you don't walk through it until way down the road. Sometimes I've gotten words and messages from God that I didn't see really fulfilled, or I didn't walk through until 10 years later. God's timing is not the same as ours, so just FYI. Right? Okay, so next thing is digital time. Now, the reason that I always keep the digital time is because for a year I woke up at 3:33, and that wound up being an address in the scripture, which was Jeremiah 33:3. And God used that scripture. I'm not going to tell you what it is. You're going to have to look it up if you don't already know. He used that scripture in my life for a very long time. So I'm just saying, sometimes you can just take the, especially if you feel prompted, I mean, follow your senses and your intuition. That's what all this is about, is learning to trust your intuition with the Spirit of God, hearing the Spirit of God. So when I get something, maybe it's 4:18, right? Then, and I wake up at in that 4 o'clock hour a lot, then what I'm going to do is I'm going to put in Google. Google is your friend. I'm just going to put in the Google browser. I'm going to ask for 4:18 in Bible. That's all I'm going to type in. 4:18 in Bible. You know what it's going to bring up? It's going to bring up every scripture in the Bible that is in every book in the Bible that has a 4:18, a chapter 4 in a scripture, a verse 18, right? Now, that has been in many, many times in my dreams, Luke 4:18, where God is just reminding me that part of my call is to bind up the brokenhearted, to cause the blind to see, and to set the captives free, which is just the way God speaks. He speaks in so many different ways. So digital times are sometimes very important. If you're not prompted to go there to the scripture, don't worry about it. Just do what you're prompted to do, what your intuition tells you, because your intuition is most likely Holy Spirit leading you in the way that you should go. If you have relationship with Him and you've refined that, that's part of what's going on. And if you haven't, then you might want to look at my See and Discover course, where we actually address some of that. And it's a 4-week mini course telling you about and helping you find and identify your gifting so that you can be more sensitive to the Spirit of God. Okay, Now, next on the list is going to be your emotion. Now, sometimes you wake up angry, fearful, hurt, or happy, joyous. Sometimes those are going to be important and sometimes they're not. However, I write them down if I am prompted. In other words, if I wake up and I'm ecstatic, I am going to write that down. It's going to be important if it's got that much emphasis on it. Next is your who, what, when, and where. Those are things that if you don't get those down immediately when you try to go through the scenario, you will lose the who, what, when, and where. You might remember one part of it, but not remember the rest of it. So who's in the dream? And if it's Susie Q, who was your best friend in high school, but it's not really Susie Q, write that down. Because sometimes unidentified people are going to be spirits in your dream. So they're going to be important. After that, who, what, what happened? Make it quick. You were going to the mailbox and a dog tried to bite you. You're just going to say what happened, right? And where is going to be, sometimes that's important because if it's at your old homestead where you were raised, that can be important because it might be about your generational line or about your past. Those are things that you're going to want to know. And then next down is going to be location of dream. Now, location of dream, I always put down because sometimes the region and the land that you are sleeping on will affect your dreams many times, actually. They will affect your dreams. If the region has a principality or which they all do, they have principalities over them, either a demonic system, and also God is a redeemer, so everything is going to have redemption. So you also have a redemptive call on the region. Because of those things, and we can talk about those later in a one-on-one class, if that's something you're interested in, then you can contact me through my website. There's a contact form on the melodypash.com site, which I assume you're maybe on. Anyway, location of dream is going to be important for those reasons. The next line says point of reference. Now, your point of reference is going to be, I had a fight with my best friend last night. And then you wind up dreaming about your best friend or your sister or your brother or whomever, right? That's a point of reference that goes here. Now, below that, I put a title, something that reminds me of the dream. Okay, a dog bit me on the way to mailbox, or I got bit on the way to the mailbox. Whatever, something that is specific enough that it really brings back the meaning of the dream to me, or the essence, or the scenario of the dream. Okay, and then you have scene and a place for your content. Now, you got plenty of room to write your content, but if you run out of room, I just go to the next page and I just keep writing. If it takes me 2 or 3 days, because I'm a big dreamer, and sometimes I'll dream 6 or 8 dreams in a night, I just keep writing until I'm done. Now, at the end, you're going to have an area where it says connecting references or notes. Those connecting references are going to be something that has a strong emphasis. This is not the same as the references we just talked about. This is that point of reference is different. This connecting reference is last year, God told me, God told me that I was going to get a very specific message and it was going to come by mail, but I was going to have opposition getting there, right? That's a point of reference for the dream that I just had, that I went to the mailbox and there was something obviously important there, but what I remembered was I went to the mailbox and a dog tried to bite me. Well, the dog is the opposition trying to keep me from the message that God is trying to give me, right? That's the point of reference, is that it actually relates, maybe even from way back. Something comes up in your spirit, you're going to want to write that down. And then you might ask why you only have 3 or 4 sentences for your interpretation. Once you get the interpretation, all you need to put down is the essence, which is kind of like what I just said to you. There was a message, a very important message that God had for me. I have trouble with the glare. There we go. I'm figuring it out. That God had for me that was for this time, but he told me about it maybe 6 months ago, right? And he warned me that there would be opposition, but I would need to get to the mailbox if I was going to get that message. So I hope that explains some things about the Now Interpret This dream journal that I published, and I hope that it will be something that will be a big help for you. You can find it on Amazon.com, either on my author page, or you can just type in Now Interpret This Dream Journal or Melody Pash, and those will come up. That will come up. So thank you for listening. I hope that you have one of the journals. If you have, thank you for purchasing. And if you haven't, please do so. I appreciate it.